Sometimes on this journey, I get lost in my mistakes. What looks to me like weakness is a canvas for your strength. And my story isn't over, my story's just begun. And failure won't define me, 'cause that's what my father does. Yeah, failure won't define me, 'cause that's what my father does.
free they fly.
Wait, how do you turn it off?
You just push it back again.
Hey, KWC family, my name is Logan Lake. I just wanted to invite you to an event at Owensboro Community and Technical College. I'm the campus ministry's leader out there. I wanted to invite you on April 10th at 6 p.m. in the Blanford Lecture Hall. We are having an event called Can We Trust the Bible? Dr. Andy Gallins from East Hartford Baptist Church is going to be the main speaker for the evening. We're going to have a couple panelists for some Q&A time afterwards. I wanted to invite you there. Thank you.
I'm Rob Lampkin. This is the famous
Grace.
And we're here to let you know about the college ministry that we are starting at Bridgepoint. 18 to 25-year-olds. 9:30 on Sunday mornings, 5 o'clock on Sunday nights. We'd love to have you. If you have any questions, feel free to hit me or Grace up.
Be there, and or don't.
Or don't. But we'd rather you be there. So just look us up if you got any questions, and we look forward to seeing you guys.
Reasons to praise you.
Welcome. As you guys know, we do like a 2 claps and a flare. So when you guys are ready, when I say 3, 2, 1, woo! Okay, let's pray, guys. Thank you for your grace, Father God. I pray that we don't lose our focus of your mercy and goodness. And as we worship, doesn't matter what who's beside or what's behind us or in front of us are thinking, but to focus on you, Father God, and that for today's message, I pray that it is Holy Spirit led. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Amen. How are you guys doing? Doing good? Well, let's all stand and let's worship together today.
Together
my eyes upon you. Together.
down. You're never gonna let, never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, never gonna let me down.
Good morning, good morning, good morning, everybody. How are we doing today? Everybody doing well? Come on now. We're a bunch of college students. We can do this. We can get better than that. Come on. How are we doing today? Come on. There we go. There we go. That's the energy I want to see. Man, thank you guys so very much to Anna and Sean. God bless you guys. Thank you so much for letting me come and speak. My name is Pastor Spencer Phillips. I pastor the church over at Legacy Owensboro here in town where the old Malco Theater used to be. Basically, just a straight shot down Frederica Street. The big black building over there is where I pastor. And I'm kind of new to all this. I just started pastoring back in June. And so my wife and I, we just moved back from Nashville. And we are just loving it. We're enjoying it. And we enjoy the city of Owensboro. It's a good place to be, and it's a college town. I don't care what anybody says. It's a college town. And so very honored to be here with you guys. For whatever reason, I'm a little nervous today. I'm like I want to do such a good job for you guys and just, you know, uplift you and encourage you and go from there. And so I know I only have about 15 minutes today, so I'm going to really try to give you a word within that time frame, okay? And so I just want to speak and talk real quick. Let's pray real fast just so we can introduce the Lord into this sermon and go from there. Lord, we thank you for this day. We thank you for all that you're doing, God. And Lord, we ask that you open our hearts to receive and open our hands to do your work, Lord, from what you've asked us to do in this season of our life, Father. Lord, we ask and we pray and we acknowledge that your presence is in the room today, Lord, and do what only you can do. And in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. So, I just want to kind of like start out with like a story, right? Is that cool? My life, I grew up in old McLean County. If you're from out of town, it's basically, hey, got some McLean County folk in the house. Let's go. Grew up in McLean County, did the sports, did all the football. Actually had a full ride to play KWC football. Man, I know I don't look like it much, but, you know, back in the day, I was all right. I was decent, you know. And so I never actually, NCAA clearinghouse got in the way and whole ordeal, right? And so I actually went into, you know, that was my identity. That's what I was going to do. I was going to play football. I was going to move forward. And I was always in church. My father pastored a church ever since I was, you know, in like elementary school. My father was a pastor, and I just followed him and kind of really just did the church thing, right? Never really had a genuine relationship with the Lord. And right after high school, you know, my dreams were shattered. Didn't get to play football. And I was just like in tears every single day. And then all of a sudden my health turned against me. And I started experiencing seizures every other day, for about 2 years. And started going through a lot of pain, a lot of issues with my body, and couldn't never really figure out why. You know, and the whole time I'm asking the Lord, why? You know, why? Why is this happening? And you may find yourself in that season this morning, and it's okay. It's okay to be in that season as long as we don't give up, right? We don't give up, we win, right? Anyway, so I started going through this season. I started going through, this journey with the Lord and pursuing a relationship, which I know we're talking about chapter 7 in our book today. That has everybody been reading their book? Everybody keeping up on that? Aw, Anna, I got no hands down here. I don't know where she's at, but... But if chapter 7 is all about pursuing of the Lord with a relationship, right? And pursuing God with a love affair, right? So I started going through this journey with whenever I was going through having seizures and all this other stuff, and I traveled a little bit. I moved to Nashville, moved to Texas, moved to California, moved back to Nashville, moved back to Owensboro, back to Nashville, and then back to Owensboro. So I was in a season there, and I'll never forget the day that I came to the Lord and was like, okay, I lay it all down. I'm laying all this down, and I'm giving you like, you know, one last shot, right? Like, I don't know, I've had that prayer before. I'm sure many of us have in the room as well. We're like, Lord, I'm coming to you one last time. I need you to show up. I need you to be there for me. And I had a dream that night, and the Lord, you know, spoke to me audibly in that dream and said, no more. I woke up the next day, and I've never had a seizure since. And the Lord completely healed me of all my seizures, of all the brain activity that was going on. And I haven't had one since this day, praise God. And so it's a really good thing. And it brings me to a point where when I finally said yes to the Lord, I pursued a love relationship with him, right? And so like the title of this is going to be Pursued by Love, right? Pursued by Love. And that's, you know, it's a pretty simple statement. You know, but what does it mean? You know, what are we talking about here? Who in here has got boyfriend, girlfriend? Most of us in the room. How about this? So I'm married, right? And so the way that I swing this, and if it's okay, I can say it like this, guys, because I like to put my own spin and twist on the book, right? How is it any different of our pursuit with the Lord versus pursuing a spouse, right? Whenever I was pursuing my wife, man, you know, okay, so let me tell you that story. So I slid into her DMs, right? I'm like, hey, what up, girl? I'm coming back from Nashville, and I see you. You're pretty. You're doing CrossFit, and I'm in CrossFit, too, and I wanted to be a part of that world, and I was much better than I am now, much better in shape than around shape, but... I saw her on the page, and, you know, I was like, hey, what's up? And I'm moving back from Nashville. Can I join you at the gym? Yes, I have a boyfriend. Wow. Okay, cool. No worries. I never crossed that boundary, right? I never like tried to like get in the way of that relationship. I just kind of sat back, but the whole entire time I pursued her from a distance, right? And every single day, she works over at Colby's. She's one of the managers there down there. Her family owns that restaurant downtown Colby's. Give me a shout out if you guys go down there. Tell them I sent you. And I would just sit in her section, right? I would just sit there. I'd get a salad, and I don't eat salads. You know, but I just wanted to be around her. I just wanted to be a part of her life. And I would bring, like, my mother was really big into, like, the essential oils, right? And so I would, like, take some of her essential oils and, like, take it to her and be like, hey, you know, that was a hard workout yesterday, right? Man, here's some oil for you, you know? You know, I didn't know. I didn't really know, like, what I wanted to do on that. But I was, but the whole point of this is to re-examine how we pursue our Father. Is to re-examine how we pursue God, right? And so we can take those like tangible stories, right, and apply it to our spiritual walk. How important is it in your life to pursue the one you love? How important is it in your life that you're willing to show up at a random time and order a salad just to sit in his section? How often do we do that within our walk with Christ, right? And so we have to pursue. God is inviting us. And a lot of my points today are just everything that you can get from the book, okay? I didn't want to like stray too far away from the book. I'm already running out of time. I didn't want to stray too far away from the book. But so most of my points and everything that you can get is in chapter 7 of your Experiencing God book. And if you don't have that, I'm sure Anna or Sean can get you that information. And so God is inviting us into a real loving relationship with him. He's inviting us into a transformation relationship with him, a forgiving and empowering relationship with him. But here's the thing. It's going to cost you something. It's going to cost you something, right? Everything, you know, the old saying is everything's got a price, right? Now it's free, but we have to say yes to it. And God doesn't want anything expensive. God doesn't care anything about your likes. God doesn't care about how many Instagram pictures you got going on, how many people are following you, if you got that check mark or not, you know, whatever the case may be, right? No, God doesn't give any two flips about that, right? What he does care about and what he does want is something valuable, and that's what? Our heart. He doesn't want anything expensive. He just wants something of value, and that means our heart. And what happens whenever you get in a relationship with somebody that you know, you're really involved, you really like that guy, you really like that girl, you give them everything, right? You give them your whole heart. You pour out, you're like, you know, texting them every morning, what's up, babe, good morning, how'd you sleep? You know, that nighttime, you know, hey, girl, you know, can we just talk on the phones for hours upon hours? And you fall in love with the relationship because you're pursuing something that you see that you can genuinely fall in love with, right? Amen. And so we have to continuously do that. He wants our heart. He wants all of us. And so, you know, the question is that comes to mind is how do we keep his will while we're in this pursuit? And life is hard, guys. Like, I know y'all are still in college, you know, but, dude, I've been there. And it's tough, you know? But at the same time, it's a life that's worth living. It's a life worth pursuing, and we all go through stuff. But it's so important that we have this, right? You got brothers and sisters. You can look around the room, and you can tag team with them, partner with them to help you through this process and help you through this life. Not every day's a tiptoe through the daisy field, you know? And so we have to come together and be together as family. And, you know, one big question that I have to ask is how do we pursue a love affair with the Father and we follow his will, right? We have to continuously follow his will. And it sums down to one word, obedience. Obedience. We have to be obedient. And, you know, if you come by and you get in the service with me on, you know, at Legacy Owensboro, you might hear me say this, immediate obedience. Immediately, we obey. We say yes. I don't know about you, but if my wife comes to me and says, hey, babe, can you please stop doing that? Or can you please do this for me? What is my response? Absolutely. Absolutely. I'm so sorry. So we have to look at that whenever we look at a relationship with the Father and he says, hey, what are you doing? I need you to give this to me. Are we going to hold it back? And say, I'm not ready to give that. I'm not ready to give that. I'm going to hold on to this because this makes me feel comfortable. This makes me feel safe. but he's asking for it. And we have to say yes to it with immediate obedience. You know, it's funny that we look in Matthew chapter 4, and I think that's actually what y'all are going through right now, right, is the book of Matthew. Am I correct in saying that? Cool. Do y'all remember in chapter 4 when Jesus basically starts his ministry and starts following, you know, and going out to get his disciples? Simon and Peter there were right there with their, you know, with their father, with his father, right? And he was like, they were just doing their thing, right? And here comes Jesus. You know, just, what's up, guys? How's it going? Drop your nets and follow me, and I will make you fishers of men. You know, there's a whole lot of context that I'm going over there, but follow me, and I will make you fishers of men. And guess what they did? The scripture says immediately they dropped their nets. They dropped everything. They dropped their family. And a lot of people don't realize this. They dropped everything. They lost their home, their parents, their life, their careers, everything that they loved doing. They left it all behind to follow Jesus. In that moment. And how often can we say that we're in our zone, we're doing our thing, and you know, and God's like, hey, can I have your attention? Just for a moment, you can get back to that video game. You can get back to that study time. You can get back to whatever, you know, fill in the blank. But how often are we willing to say, yes, I'm here, Lord, and lay down everything and focus on him? We have full access. Everybody say full access. We have full access to the Lord. Every single one of us has full access and to have a relationship with him, to have a tangible, real relationship with the Father. If our relationship is not right, nothing in our life will be in order. Nothing in our life will be in order. And I promise you, if you're on that fence line today, and you're like, man, like I really want to step into this relationship, I really want to step into this God thing, right? It's your day. Today is your day. And all you have to do is say yes. And the harder thing to do with that is say yes and also give your heart, right? So, if our relationship is not right, then everything is going to be out of order. So let me ask you another question. I'm a big question. I got about 5 minutes. This is going to be perfect timing. Right, Anna, 5 more minutes? Cool. What are your priorities in life? Think about it for just a moment. Write it down. Write it down in your journal if that's, you know. And I want you to take this week and pray about that. Focus on that and ask the Lord, what are your priorities? Is it sports first? Is it, you know, I don't know, family? Is it school? Is it what you do in life? Is it, you know, the things that you do that brings you all this identity? Is that number one? Or are we organizing our priorities now, early, before we get into adulthood and you're out of college, you're doing your own thing? And if we can set that groundwork now and focus and keep the main thing, and that is what? God, number one priority, right? And then family, church, those are my top three, right? God, family, church. And I'm a pastor, but my family comes first, right? It has to. So I ask yourself, everybody in here wants a future. Everybody in here has got goals and visions and big plans, right? Everybody. But if those goals and those plans are superseding, you know, the Father, nothing in your life is going to fall in order. I promise you. It may for a season. It may for a year. It may for two. It may go on for 5 or 6 years. You may get married. You have all the kids. And you feel great about everything. But one day, I promise you, you're going to have this empty hole in your heart where you never allowed it to be filled with the only person ever to fill it. And that's Jesus. Amen? Amen. And so, one last little story as I'm landing the plane here. How many of you got like nieces and nephews, or maybe even kids, right? I got 7 nieces and nephews. My wife and I don't have any kids yet, and so we're gonna get there. But you know, whenever you play hide and seek with like the toddler, right? When they go to hide, they're just kind of like hiding, like right here, you know, like can't see me. I'm hidden. But to us, it's so easy to see them, right? It's so easy to see that child that's just like hiding behind this podium that you can clearly see through, right? It's got a little shade, but you can clearly see the child, right? And a lot of times whenever it's our turn to go seek or whenever it's our turn to hide, I'm going to hide in a place where the kid can find me. I'm not going to go hang up the top of the rafters where the toddler can't get to me, right? And so we look at this in a way, if I can say it like this, is that we're playing, you know, potentially can play a game with God at hide and seek, right? And a lot of times we are the toddler and we think that God's in a place where we can't find him. We think that we're in a position and we're seeking his face. We're seeking God, right? But the whole time he's in a place where we just see him exactly where he's at, plain as day. But what does it require for us to see? Seek. Seek his face. Seek his face. You know, Moses, if we go to the book of Exodus, Moses went to his tent every single morning to see God face to face. As a friend, as you and I are talking today, as I'm talking to you, to see God face to face every single morning. Every single morning. And that's what we have to do. We must seek God to have a face-to-face encounter with him every single day. It's daily bread, not yesterday's bread. It's daily bread, right? And a lot of us have said yes to the Father and said yes to our relationship with God, but we refuse to eat new food that he gives us each and every day, and we've been living off the leftovers of yesterday's encounter. Does that make sense? You with me? And so it's our responsibility, it's our job to seek his face each and every day, to pursue a love relationship with him every single day, so that way we can be fed and that we can be properly nourished spiritually. It's not your pastor's job. It's not Sean's job. It's not Anna's job. It's nobody else's job except for yours to fall at the feet of Jesus and give him everything you've got. Don't let them go up to the mountaintop and bring a word to bring it back down to you, right? Does that make sense? Seek his face. Go after it because I promise you it's worth it. Amen? Amen. I'm out of time, but God bless you guys. I love you so, so very much. And if y'all have any questions for me, please, I'll be right down here. If you want some prayer time, please come and see me. And I know that we have somebody coming up to pray us out. I believe this gentleman here. Look at this guy, a stud. Come on. Let's help him and support him, and God bless you.
Heavenly Father, Lord, I just thank you for this opportunity to come here and fellowship today, Lord. I pray that during this time, Lord, that you just open our minds and open my hearts to your Holy Spirit. I pray that we can leave this place and go out into this campus and to be a light for you and to do your will, Lord. I just pray that you go before us, be with us, and keep us safe throughout the rest of this week. In Jesus' name, amen.